We could not be more excited at this moment. He is one of the most outspoken and brilliant filmmakers of our time. Here to tell us all about his new film, Shock and Awe. Welcome, Rob Reiner.
Thanks for having me, you guys.
We're so happy to have you. I was thinking before this, you've done so much. Just reading over your bio is incredible. What do people know you the most from?
I think probably from All in the Family. I mean, because that's what they've seen me on television. Well, I don't look anything like I did. My kids, when they look at it, they go, "It sounds like you, Dad, but it doesn't look like you."
All right, well, you are directing and starring in Shock and Awe, which is a movie about former President Bush's invasion of Iraq back in 2003. What was so important about that time that you wanted to do this movie?
Well, you know, I was of draft age during the Vietnam War, and I just couldn't believe, as we were marching to war, that we were again, in my view, going to war based on lies and faulty intelligence. And so I wanted to make the movie back then, and initially I thought, well, I'll make it as a satire, you know, like a Dr. Strangelove kind of thing. Couldn't get a script right, and then I saw this documentary by Bill Moyers, who was LBJ's press secretary, and it was all about these four journalists from Knight Ridder News who got it all right. They figured it out. They were able to dig down and understand there was no connection between Saddam Hussein and al-Qaeda. There was no definite evidence of weapons of mass destruction. And they got it right, but they couldn't break through. Right. There was a headwind of patriotism. The press was all buying into what the Bush administration was selling. And it's a cautionary tale about how important it is for the press to do the job and get the truth to the American people, because as we say at the beginning of the film, democracy sits and rests on whether or not we have a free and independent press.
So I gotta tell you, I was a member of the press at that time. I was working at CNN and covered the first few weeks of the war from an aircraft carrier in the Persian Gulf. And I have to say that it's easy to look back and say the press should have done this.
Yeah.
At the time, covering in the lead up to the war, we would try to go out and find people who were opposing the run up to the war, and it was difficult. And I wonder, how much did you stand up then?
I think that was the problem. For the mainstream press, the country was traumatized by 9/11, and we all wanted to be patriots, and we didn't want to not agree with our administration because we didn't want to act as if we were not patriotic. And I think that was the headwind that most of the press faced.
My point is, it wasn't just the press, and I think it's easy to sit here many years later and blame the press.
Oh, no, I'm not blaming the press, because it wasn't just the press. I mean, we point out in the film, Hillary Clinton voted to authorize the war. John Kerry, Joe Biden, these were all people who subsequently have said it was a mistake to make that vote, but they were there too. People were caught up in it. But the one thing that we talk about, and my character says it in the film, is that when the government says something, you only have one question to ask. Is it true?
Interesting.
And that's really the basis of all journalism. And we, even when we are overwhelmed by patriotism and wanting to feel like we're, you know, doing the right thing for the country, we still have to distance ourselves and say, is it true? And I think right now the press is under attack more than ever before. You know, you have a president calling him the enemy of the people and fake news. And I think it's even more incumbent now to really dig down and get to the truth.
Let's take a look at a clip from this, because obviously it's got us all talking. I think it's shock and awe. Here's a look.
Saddam Hussein now has weapons of mass destruction.
They're dialing up the rhetoric on Iraq. Let's see if we can nail them down, okay? Let's get to work.
We're working on a theory that the administration has already decided to go to war and is now focused on how to justify it.
It's not a theory.
We're working on something important. That's why I'm here, to make you an offer.
It's Joe Galloway.
Wow.
Man even walks like he has a Bronze Star.
What do you want to know?
Everything the administration doesn't want us to know.
A secret war planning group has been set up in the building where I work.
And which building is that?
The one with five sides.
Wow. Wow, goosebumps.
Yeah.
You know, we were asking before we went on air, is it hard to make journalism look exciting and look sexy? Because, I mean, we do it, and so I can say for a lot of us it's not. You know, is it hard to make it look that way?
Well, I think you start out by trying to make it look real. Mm-hmm. I mean, to make it look honest and look like it what it really is. I don't think we're shooting for sexy necessarily.
Right.
But we were lucky because the four journalists who the story it's about, they were there with us the whole time and making sure that we were doing what really happened.
Interesting.
Yeah. What did they think about the end result, the film?
Well, they were thrilled with it because they were with us all the way.
Yeah.
They oversaw this writing of the scripts. They were on the set with us. So they were very happy with how it was portrayed.
It's an amazing cast, by the way. It's Woody Harrelson, Tommy Lee Jones, Jessica Biel, many more. Obviously, you. So happy to have you in. You're a legend.
Hey, thank
so
you.
Happy to
Thanks
have you
for
here.
Having me.
All right, don't miss Shock and Awe in theaters starting this Friday and available on video on demand. Thanks again.
Thanks, Rob.